You won't believe this program. Where else are you going to find the Chippendales on the same show with the Dallas Cowboy Cheerleaders? Well, I am pleased to present, first of all, I'd ask you who you want first, but I'm afraid you might tell me. Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. No kidding. These are the real live, and if you think it's easy to become one of this group, you try it. Here are fashioning for us, modeling for us, what you just have to have for the beach this summer. You should have two of each pair. Here are the Dallas Cowboy Cheerleaders. Say hello to these folks here.
Let's take a look at Carrie. Carrie is wearing Bill Black. This is a beautiful orange fringe swimsuit with a matching cover-up mile made of Anton nylon and Lycra. This is Alona in Speedo America, ultra high-tech look with the combination of mesh and solid. It is $58, and look at those great eyeglasses. Aren't those fun? We'll tell you more about those in a minute. Say hello to Deon. Deon is wearing a great-looking suit. Again, this is by Speedo America. It's in a siliconized Lycra spandex Anton nylon suit. And those great glasses she's wearing are from a company called Mercuray, and they do really wild, way-out, whimsical glasses. Thanks, Deon. Let's take a look now at Sue. Say hello to Sue. This suit is from a company called Exposé. It has the fringe detail around the bra in a leopard print. It also has a matching shawl. This is made of spun polyester and Lycra, and because of the polyester in it, it helps to hold the color, and you can wash it lots of times. It'll look as good as new forever. Thanks, Sue. This is Judy. Judy's wearing an outfit from a company called Body Glove. Body Glove has this sheer little cover-up with a studded bandeau in neoprene, and the swimsuit is $95. The body of the suit is Lycra spandex. Say hello to Toni. She's wearing a suit from a company called Too Hot Brazil. We talked about the bra influence in the leopard suit. Here you see the detail of the bra hooks on this suit, and it has its matching cover-up. Because of the Lycra spandex in it, this swimsuit will dry instantly.
Very pretty.
This is Leslie. Leslie is wearing a great-looking suit that's slightly off the shoulder with those great lime-colored thunderbirds around it, and it has some interesting back detail there. This suit is by a company called Exposé. It's made of spun polyester and Lycra. And this is Kourtney in an outfit from Harbor Casuals. It's 100% cotton terry wrap robe with the print on the back of the robe that matches the print on the swimsuit. It's a bandeau suit and graffiti print. This is made of water-bright nylon.
We want to show off now the Dallas Cowboys Cheerleaders. You see them on Sunday afternoon as well as Monday night. And it's become very much a staple of America's, one of America's most favorite athletic pastimes, professional football. But they do more than cheer. This is a very talented group of young women. Let's look on now as they strut their stuff for us here in good old New York City. Come on out here, Dallas Cowboys Cheerleader.
Thank you.
Now, you are going to pass any audition for any Broadway show. We are impressed. You guys do not smoke cigarettes. Here are Leslie Haynes. Let's let these talented young women catch their breath here. Leslie Haynes is director of the Dallas Cowboys Cheerleaders, and Shannon Worthman joins us as well. You are the choreographer. Well, how proud you must be of this very, very talented group of people who, an organization which became, I think, famous in the mid-70s. Do I have this right?
That's correct, Phil.
Along with the America's Team, back in the glory days.
Well, we're headed for the future, and we're looking for an enthusiastic year.
I bet you are. You got a new coach, and I know you miss Coach Landry, but, hey, life goes on, and I'm sure he'll be watching on his own television somewhere in America.
We hope so. We hope everybody will stay Cowboy fans and continue to be and support the Dallas Cowboys.
Let me ask you now, how does one... This is a very competitive... You don't have to live in Texas to be a member, do I understand
that? That's correct. We have women that try out from all over the country.
And if you don't live in Texas and you make the team, so to speak, you do have to move to the Metroplex, I'm sure.
Yes, that's correct.
Uh-huh. And you have to be 18.
That's right.
And you can be 80.
You can. We've had women try out that were in their 60s and 70s.
Uh-huh. Would you know how old your oldest in the history of the cheerleaders, how old has the oldest member been?
34.
Well, we want to meet her, don't we? Where's her book? You have an awful lot to do during the off season as well. I'm sure you travel this group and.
We really don't have an off season. We travel on USO Department of Defense tours. We do a lot of charity work for the Variety Club, so we are very active. Even when everybody calls it the off season, it is our season too.
Well, you know, as you know, I'm from New York, so you got to watch me very closely. I don't think there's anything particularly untoward about these costumes. I think they're very modest and very lovely and very appropriate.
Well,
I say that in advance of the following question. You certainly had your share of publicity about this. Not a few folks were a little bit upset that we had such attractive and well-conditioned young women out there doing what we've been accustomed to see young women do at football games. Do you remember that controversy? Has that pretty well passed?
That has passed, and we've had an outstanding year. Certainly, it was cause for concern. Our uniform is a trademark that is recognized around the world. These ladies can show up in Turkey or Bahrain or Panama and Honduras, and they know who they are. So we don't want to change something that works.
I wouldn't either. And I... How many... Do I understand, how many are in the full contingent? I don't think this is the full contingent, is it?
We have 32 young ladies.
32.
That make up the full squad.
And do you go to the away games as well, all 30?
We do not travel to the away games.
I see.
Weekends, we either participate at nursing homes or other charity events or for corporate events.
Uh-huh. And I assume you have countless numbers of women audition every year or try out. Is that how we say
it? We do. We're going through our auditions right now back in Texas, and we have over 500 young ladies that have traveled from all over the country to come audition.
Well, please stand by, and let's entertain some phone some questions from the audience here. These, I bet you do. Sure, there's a guy in the back row. Hang on just one second. Let me get, now that you're getting your wind back, we'll be able to Actually, are you there, caller?
Yeah, hi.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Hey, today, are you kidding?
I was just wondering, are the cheerleaders allowed to date the Dallas Cowboys?
You know, it's funny, the host is supposed to ask the most important questions here. What do you say? How do you feel about that, Leslie?
There Shannon? Is absolutely no fraternization allowed at all with the players. That's our number one rule.
Why is that?
Why? We are their fans, and that's how we want to be associated with them, period.
Yes. We want you to, we want the players to keep their eyes on the pass, you know. Yeah.
Phil, do most of the cheerleaders have occupations other besides being Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders?
Yes, they're all nodding with affirmation. Yes.
They are required to go to school or be students full-time, or we've had several mothers on the squad that stay home and take care of their children. Yes.
Do they have regulation weights and measures?
We don't have them on according to any kind of weight scale. One of the prerequisites of being a Cowboys cheerleader is that you look good in the uniform. So as long as they look good, that's fine.
We are. We will in a moment see again the following members of the Dallas Cowboys cheerleaders, including Alona Wood, Toni Tawater, Sue Hollingsworth, Judy London, Kourtney Mitchell, Leslie Ezelle, Deon Sharp, and Carrie Blanke. And we'll all be waiting with more than a little enthusiasm for your return. I thank you all for a wonderful performance. Uh-huh. Go chat and ask questions of the Dallas Cowboys cheerleaders, and we'll give them that opportunity. But first, let us see them as they model, with their ever-perfect bodies, the latest in swimwear, if you please.
Well, Phil, you know, we were showing one-piece swimsuits before. By the way, do you know that 77% of all swimsuits sold in America are one-piece swimsuits? But now we're going to take a look at some two-piece swimsuits, and here's Carrie again in a two-piece brilliant color swimsuit by a company called Citrus. It's made of cotton and lycra. And here comes Alona. You're probably wondering why I mentioned the names of the fibers in all of these swimsuits. And I'm going to tell you why. This three-piece outfit she's wearing is from a company called Sassafras. And this is their water wiggle pattern with a matching sarong. But the reason I mentioned the fibers is because the fibers are really what has revolutionized swimwear and made swimwear so terrific looking. Thanks, Alona. Let's take Deon. The interesting thing about the fibers is that the high technology makes you not only look good, but makes the swimsuit perform for you. It performs in two ways. One is because it has lycra spandex in it, and I'm going to talk about that as we go on. This is by Body Glove. It's two pieces, and it has the little bra top. This is a very important fashion feature, the bra influence in swimwear, and the little matching skirt. The company is Body Glove, designed by Robin Picone. And here we have Sue, and this swimsuit she's wearing is from La Blanca. It's a tropical print sarong, and this one features what we call a molded bra cup. There's a new interest in the bandeau bras not being flattening on the bosom, so these are what we call molded bra tops. And that's by La Blanca. Here's another look from La Blanca, the neon green and black that you're looking at here on Judy. And all of the hair accessories and the eyeglasses that you're seeing in this segment are from Riviera. And here we have Toni. And Toni is showing you a swimsuit from Malibu Dream Girl. This is cotton and lycra, three pieces. And this is a suit that's sold in three parts. She's wearing a little crop top, and the other part is a little strapless bandeau. So you buy all three pieces, and you can wear one for sunning and one for working out. Also, this is called a rollikini, and as you can see, Toni's going to show you it can be worn very high up on the body, so if you like a lot of coverage, you can do that. But you adjust it as to what's perfect for you, and for Toni's body, she likes to wear it just there. Thanks, Toni. And this suit is also from a company called Sassafras. This is their crayon print. Now, what you're seeing here is these wonderful bright colors. And if you ever wonder where the bright color comes from, that's because it's DuPont's Antron nylon. And that fiber gives the swimsuit color, its luster and its sheen. And you can spend hours in the sun and hours in the washing machine if you would. And it won't lose its color because of the high technology fiber in it. This is from a company called Jimmy Z, and you're looking at this on Kourtney. This is what we call color clashing, the bright corals and the hot pinks. And she's got a two-piece bikini with a little skort.
and a matching jacket. And all these pieces are made, again, with the Lycra spandex in it so that the fiber gives the suit its shape.
Our gorgeous, all of you. Thank you. We've asked these beautiful women to come out and we just want to look at you, as we always do. I'll tell you, you make the timeouts worthwhile. If you joined us late, these are, no doubt about it, the Dallas Cowboys cheerleaders, and they work for their position on this team, so to speak, because there are lots of tryouts. There's, I assume, semis and final cuts. And incidentally, once you make the team, you got to make it again. I assume you have to, not unlike the players, you have to make sure you're current every year. Are you there, caller? I'm glad you waited. Hi.
Yes, I am.
Go ahead.
I want to know how the girls deal with being sex objects and having boyfriends.
How do you deal with being sex objects? Well, actually, I'm used to it by now. Oh, you mean, I'm sorry. Yes, help us.
Well, we really don't feel like we're sex objects. We feel like we're just the all-American girl. We're athletes, we're dancers, and we love football.
Well, you certainly are athletes, as we saw from, yes? Yes.
I just wanted to know, does it pay? Is there a salary involved?
We didn't see you, and you'll never be a star if we don't do that. go ahead.
Is there a salary for being a Dallas Cowboy cheerleader?
Very little. We don't do it for the money. We get $15 a game, a home game, and after taxes, that's about $13.95.
So you're not going to retire then on this?
No.
are you there, caller? Go ahead.
Yes, I have a question for the Dallas cheerleaders.
Yes.
The woman had mentioned that there were, 33 cheerleaders, and
yes,
that there are tryouts happening right now or whatever.
Right.
Do they have to wait for people to leave? Do they have to wait for girls to leave the cheerleaders before they have tryouts? Like, do they have to wait for three to leave and then they'll hold tryouts and they'll...
No, you don't get this job forever. Why don't you tell us about it, Body Glove? I'm reading your bathing suit.
We have auditions every year, no matter how many are coming in or going. We have auditions regularly every year for open new spots.
Yes. You wanted to stand? So.
Yeah. I wanted to know, do you work out every day?
Yes, we do. Especially if we're getting ready to have a performance, we practice about 3 to 4 hours a night, and that's Monday through Friday.
I can't get by the mannequins. They won't move. That's part of the deal here, so come on down here. Yes.
Yeah. I know there's always...
Don't punch them there. They'll fall over.
If I don't fall. There's always a big joke about cheerleaders and how much they really know about football. Do any of you really know a whole lot about the game?
Yes, we are tested during our final audition, and we are tested on football, current events, and just all types of...
Yes. Yes. So, yes, you do have to know about X's and O's. Yes, and the nickel defense.
Did any of you ever have any children?
There are a few on the squad that have children.
With those bodies?
That's considered, yes, and they look fabulous. That is considered to be a full-time job, so that is accepted, and they do a wonderful job.
Yes.
Great. How you doing, Phil? I'd just like to say that you girls are much better than the L.A. Laker girls. Much prettier.
Sure. That ought to get you a free ticket to the forum. Would you kindly hand the microphone to the first woman in the line, I should say. Was Paula Abdul a Dallas Cowboys cheerleader?
She was a Los Angeles Lakers girl.
Okay. Well, that I have been asked to ask you by a caller, and now that we've set the record straight and allayed the confusion across Heartland, I will ask you to kindly take your leave, change into the next garment that we're going to ask you to show off for us here, and then do we want the young men to return? All right. Thank you very much. Consistent with our effort to bring you the latest in fashion, here's what you will see on the beach. I'll tell you what, it's new and it's almost solid black. How about this?
Well, Phil, what we're going to talk about now is the influence of designers in fashion, and you might want to see if the audience wants to take a quick guess. What designer influence do you think this is? How about Chanel with all the gold? A little bit of the Chanel influence in this swimsuit. It's by a company called La Blanca. It's made of cotton and lycra. And you're looking at it on Alona, and it's $65 for the cardigan, $54 for the swimsuit by La Blanca. This is Judy, the designer influence here on Garo.
Ongaro is famous for the beautiful, brilliant floral prints and that detail of hand tucking. And so LaBlanca hand tucked the entire bodice of this swimsuit against that slick black torso. This is made of Antron nylon and Lycra spandex. So that's why you have that brilliant color thanks to the Antron nylon. Here's Leslie. Want to take a guess at this designer influence? How about Azzedine Alaya? The slinky little dresses that are so popular. Well, what Leslie's wearing here is a skirt. Uh-oh, looks like somebody just came to life. Leslie's got the skirt, and here's the swimsuit. Turn around, Leslie, so they can see that great-looking swimsuit. This is in nylon and lycra. It's what we call a neo-knit, and it's a real sculptured body shape. Okay, thanks, Leslie. Okay, now we're going to talk about the retrospective influence in fashion. Do you remember Esther Williams, Phil? This is a real Esther Williams look, and of course, the company is Esther Williams. It is 40s feeling, but modern construction. It's a two-piece sheared sheath. And here is its companion suit, also designed by Esther Williams. Look at this gorgeous color. Again, the color is because of the fiber. This is Antron nylon, giving you that brilliant color that simply won't fade. And the great glasses that we're looking at, Mercuray glasses. And that is Sue. Okay, this suit that you're looking at here is by Janssen. It's on Kourtney, and this is the one-piece halter style. And again, this is retrospective of the 50s, and it has that beautiful floral print by Janssen. Thank you, Kourtney. And another important fashion influence is the neon brights and what we call color blocking. This is Toni in the zip back tank, in the zip front tank. Sorry, and that's the X detail on the back. It's real sleek fitting. And again, because of the elasticity in Lycra spandex, you get that really superb fit and yet the elasticity so that your suit moves with you. So if you're doing active wear things, the suit is really flexible and comfortable. This is Deon, and you're looking at another LaBlanca suit. This is a two-piece color block suit with what they call the athletic bra top, and you've got great freedom of movement in this. And those are Riviera sunglasses she's wearing with it. Okay, thanks, Deon.
Okay, let's go with the Dallas Cowboys cheerleaders. Let's see.
Okay.
Now, this is, you got a little Texas there for us.
We thought this would be perfect to begin our finale with. You're looking at Toni in a fabulous two-piece fringe suit with a royal glitter blue color. This is by Pam and Tabby for a company called Why Things Burn. It's $75, and it's a real hot look. Thanks, Toni. We're going to keep the girls moving pretty quickly here because we have so many things to show you. This is Judy in a two-piece fringe look with a matching pario designed by Lori Solomon for a company called Betengav. And Betengav is a Hebrew idiom for lying in the sun. So if you say to somebody, what are you doing? Betengav, lying in the sun. That's the name of the swimwear company. Why Things Burn. This is Sue wearing Why Things Burn. It's a gorgeous swimsuit. This is black stretch lycra with one shoulder and a really interesting asymmetric detail look. A beautiful suit. $80 is the price on this suit. Here comes Deon. And here are those great ornate scroll glasses again by Mercuray. And she's wearing a beautiful swimsuit by Pierre Cardin. Look at that rich gold embroidery scroll work on that suit. This is really a gorgeous suit. This is all about the influence of opulence and elegance in fashion. It's made of Antron nylon and Lycra spandex again. And by Pierre Cardin, it's $58. This is a company called H2O. You're seeing this on Kourtney. This is a real high-style avant-garde swimsuit, an elegant high-neck zip tank with the studded detail down the front. This is a blend of cotton and Lycra, $66. And of course, a beautiful suit on a gorgeous girl. The biker influence in fashion, isn't this fun? This is Leslie. She was worried you would think she was a real biker girl, and I promised her I'd tell you this is not the real Leslie. But we thought it would be fun to show you the influence of rock and rollers on fashion, because this suit is also by Lori Solomon of Betengav. It's studded leather, and we've just put it together like this to give you a little feeling of the influence of rock and roll on swimwear. Here is Alona looking absolutely gorgeous. This is the kind of swimwear you really want to wear for evening. This is by Bodacious Bodies out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. They're famous for their ribbon knit detailing on Lycra. And this is a two-piece Brazilian cut with its beautiful sheer wrap pario. It's priced at $95 and it's really gorgeous. And do I need to say anything?
It's Waikiki wedding.
This is gorgeous. This is the bridal suit by Bodacious Bodies out of Fort Lauderdale. A gorgeous look, and if you met on the beach and you want to celebrate your wedding day on the beach, Carrie is the bride on the beach.
Thank you all.